spoke to any group of people, she summoned everyone who had come before her. Everyone who had said a kind word, done a kind thing for her, she brought them on stage with her. So I come here standing as one, but I also come as 10,000. So that's who stands before you today. And this is really a full circle moment for me, because in 2007, I was in you all's shoes at Savannah State University. I was approached by the Savannah section of NCNW to start a collegiate section at Savannah State University. So myself, along with 28 other women, started, chartered the collegiate section of NCNW at Savannah State University. So I'm on the history books there, a little kudos to me. I was the first vice president at Savannah State University, so it's really a pleasure to be here with you today. So I'm gonna get straight into it. I have 3 points that I'm gonna make. The first one is, know where you come from and know who you belong to. Know where you come from and know who you belong to. So if you did not know it before, you are connected. Before you joined the ranks of this magnanimous organization, you are connected. You represent something. Not only the people who have come before you in your family, your mother, your aunt, so on and so forth, but you're connected to each other. You matter because you come from a lineage of greatness. Black women, as you've seen on the t-shirts, did not just become magic. We've been magic, right? We didn't need t-shirts to tell us that. We didn't need social media to tell us that. We've been magic. Black women just didn't start rocking. We've been rocking before Beverly Bonds created Black Girls Rock and before BET decided to put it on television. We've been rocking. Black girls have been magic since Makeda, Queen of Sheba, Sepsu, and Zynga of ancient Africa. We've been rocking since Sarah Bartman, also known as Hot and Top Venus, Sojourner Truth, as we heard in the poem today, Harriet Tubman, Ida B. Wells Barnett, Ella Baker, Fannie Lou Hamer. If you don't know those names, I encourage you to look them up. It is important that you remember, and I'm using the word remember intentionally, remember that you are connected, because it's something we intrinsically know already. And we come into this world connected as Black women. It is important that you remember where you come from and who you belong to. It's important that you recognize your obligation to those who stand with you today, those who come before you, and those who will come after you. We absolutely have an obligation to each other. This whole concept is called victim kinship. It's the idea that when you see a black woman doing something, you feel connected to her. It is the reason why we can see Michelle Obama on television and be proud that her hair is laid, that we can be proud of her speech at the Democratic National Convention. It's the reason that we can be proud of Ava DuVernay for what she's doing in film. We can be proud of rappers like Nicki Minaj and Dreezy just for their representation. I'm not gonna get on their message, that's a whole other thing. But we can be proud that they're there. It is also the reason that we can feel intense sadness, intense anger when one of us is killed, like Sandra Bland. It is the reason that we can feel deep hurt when we see a young sister thrown down by the police officers, either in class or out just leaving the pool, as we saw last summer. We're connected. So, and it's also when I was younger, and I was on college campuses, when I pledged my sorority, that was the thing that I had the hardest time coming to grips with. That I no longer just represented me. I represented my line sisters, I represented the organization. I was then Michelle the Delta, right? That's what I did. I couldn't walk out my house looking a mess. If I chose to speak up in class, I represented something. But I have the understanding that I'm imparting to you now that I've been connected before then, right? I represent something. And so one of my favorite shows, one of my favorite people is Oprah, my favorite network. Iyanla said on a recent episode of her show, I'm not my sister's keeper. I am my sister. That's the charge to recognize that we are all connected and we are obligated to each other. So that means if somebody, especially connected in the way that we are, tries to hold you accountable for anything, you know, have to take it with a grain of salt and acknowledge that she sees something in herself in you and she's taking that time to impart that wisdom out of love for you, not out of judgment. Know who you are and know where you come from. Second point, retail combination with everything in my body, I can guard you from the hurt that you've already experienced and that you may experience in the future. But that would absolutely be doing you a disservice. I am who I am today because of the hurt I have experienced. I am who I am today because of the struggles I have endured. Anything else taking that away from me would take away from the character and who I have built myself into today. But that again, it's not who you are. It's what you have experienced. It's what has happened to you. As long as you allow any negative thing that has happened to you or any hurt that maybe you have inflicted upon someone else to be the story that you tell about yourself, it will control you. So tell a new story about yourself. Change the script that you allow to loop over and over in your head. There's power in your thoughts. Only you know the things that you say about yourself late at night while you're laying in the bed, maybe alone with somebody else. It's cuffing season. But only you know those thoughts that you share in your head. Only you know the thoughts that you tell yourself about yourself as you're walking along the promenade, as you're walking to class with your headphones in. Only you know the thoughts that you're telling about yourself. So take ownership of that. So just like I get tired of seeing black women in media hypersexualized, depicted as hangry or hood, I also yearn for a new story to be told about black women. And for myself personally, I got tired of telling myself, who do you think you are? You can't live up to the hype. Because right now I'm a doctoral student, which means next year I'll be Dr. Allen. Y'all have me come talk, that title will be a little bit different. The reason you're at a college campus today, the reason you're here today, let you know, yeah, I can talk like this, and I can speak another way too, but I am actively embracing everything about me so that I can tell a new story about what it is to be a black woman born on the west side of Atlanta, mother addicted to drugs, father in prison. I'm telling a new story about what it looks like to be an educated black woman in this country today. I'm playing to respectability politics. My leg is full of tattoos. That's how I express myself, but that doesn't make me any less intellectual. It doesn't make me any less of a black woman, because I am creating a space for black women like me. I'm creating a space for you, right? I'm Big Sis up here talking to y'all. Not anybody on a pedestal or anything like that. I'm doing what I can to make sure that the knowledge that I wish I had when I was 19, 20, 21, 22, that I can give that to you all. And it may not resonate right now. You may graduate from college and then something I say may sink in later. But what I do know is after listening to me speak today, if you make the choice to be held back by the story you tell about yourself, if you make the choice to remain confined and restrained and restricted by other people's expectations of you, that's on you. Because knowledge is a one-way street. You can't unlearn something. Once you know something and you hear it and you make the choice to not act on it, you're making the choice to be willfully ignorant, like most.